Hey, and welcome to our video about staking with a specific focus on KleverChain. Today, we'll be discussing what staking is, the benefits of staking, and the difference between APR and FPR staking interest types. Staking is a process that allows users to lock up their cryptocurrencies in a wallet in order to participate in the validation and creation of new blocks on a blockchain, as well as support a specific project offering staking on their asset. It can greatly contribute to ensuring the overall health and security of a blockchain network, the liquidity of an asset, preventing sell-offs, and building long-term community support. One of the clear main benefits of staking is the ability to earn passive income on your crypto holdings. By staking your coins, you can earn interest on your assets, which can help you grow your holdings over time. At KleverChain, all fungible Klever Digital Assets, or KDAs, are fit for staking. However, KLV and KFI have some singular and unique features. A KleverChain node that holds 10 million KLV or more is eligible to be a validator on the blockchain. And for KFI, the stakers of this token will have the right to vote on proposals. Moreover, regular users can accumulate more of these assets through the freeze and claim contracts. When users interact with KleverChain to create their own assets, they will be faced with two types of staking: APR and FPR staking. APR staking stands for annual percentage rate. It is a well-known term in the market that represents the percentage earned annually on an asset. On KleverChain, when creating an asset and choosing this staking option, the creator must choose what the annual return will be for users who stake their token. It will be up to the creator to control the emission limits of their token, primarily through defining the initial and max supply. A good thing to note is that the return on staking is always made in the currency in which the staking was originally made. The KDA creator does not need to control the distribution of rewards since it occurs automatically on KleverChain. For users, they will simply need to claim the rewards when they meet the conditions. And on the other hand, FPR stands for Flexible Proportional Return. It is a new staking feature that the Klever ecosystem offers. When creating a fungible KDA and choosing this option, a pool will be created for depositing any asset from KleverChain. This pool will always be fed by the owner of the asset. And after the deposits are made, the stakers of that token during the deposit period will have the right to withdraw the assets deposited in the pool according to the amount of stake they made of the owner's token. Let's break it down. If a user creates coin A with FPR staking and deposits assets B, C, D, and E into their pool, a staker who holds 10% of all staking of assets A will be entitled to receive 10% of all assets of B, C, D, and E that were deposited into the pool in that epoch, provided that the staker had staked those 10% at the time of deposit and only for that deposit. If in the next deposit the staker no longer has any token staked of asset A, they will not be entitled to receive the deposited assets. For a staker to be eligible for withdrawing the rewards, they must have staked in an epoch prior to the deposit itself. If a situation arises when the owner deposits the tokens but there are currently no stakers from their assets on that epoch, that means that no one will receive the deposited coins, and after 100 epochs, they will return to the owner. The great advantage of FPR staking is that it allows the owner of an asset to create additional incentives for supporters of the project to hold their specific asset, as they will not only receive yields from their own token, but also from other assets. It's important to note that although KLV and KFI are considered to have the FPR system, their staking returns are always made in their own currency, that is KLV or KFI, and the distribution is automatic through KleverChain. We hope this covered the differences between APR and FPR staking, as well as shined a light on the overall benefit and characteristics of staking. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment below. We'd absolutely love that.